Good morning. Okay, right. Okay, then. Today's session is on management of discipline. Management of discipline. So employee discipline. The relevant objectives, learning outcomes. So these are the learning outcomes. Please read yourself and then try to understand. Okay, then definition. So what is discipline? Discipline involves controlling work and behavior of employees in compliance with all the relevant rules and regulations in order to achieve organizational goals and objectives. That's the definition given here. So it involves, you know, under discipline, we have to control work of employees and also behavior of employees. Because work is critical, that's why work has been mentioned in the definition, and also the behavior in compliance with all the relevant rules and regulations. So in any organization, there are so-called rules and regulations. The abbreviation is RR. So we call the abbreviation RR. Well, it's brief, you know, shortly further. You know, we can simply mention our rules. Okay, so there are rules and regulations which were imposed by the owner manager or the relevant top managers, you know, for controlling work and behavior of employees. Because, you know, there are organizational goals and objectives. So the organization will not be able to achieve organizational goals and objectives without employee discipline. Discipline is a very, very important thing. Very, very important thing. Right. So then you can see here the definition of discipline administration. So I have defined discipline administration as the development, implementation, and maintenance of an appropriate discipline system or disciplinary system in the organization in order to accomplish its goals. Again, Sangvidhane Paramarthi Ituvanuvas Yogya Vinaya Paddhatiya Athikirima Kriyatmakirima Saha Nadattukirima Patthwaginaya. So therefore, we have to develop a disciplinary system. Of course, that should be appropriate, and that has to be developed, and then that has to be implemented, and then that has to be maintained continuously. Right. So that is discipline administration. So in simple, you know, in singular, vinaya kiyala kiyanne yahapath hasirima. Ewa naththam sikshane. Yana avul viyavul akramikata aakulata vyakulata saha visamacha. ඔය සියල්ලංගෙම තොර ඒ සියල්ල නොමැති තත්ත්වයක් තමයි විනය කියලා කියන්නේ. අපි මෙතනදී සඳහන් අදාළ කියන්නේ අපි ඉගෙන ගන්න උගන්වන්නේ කර්මාන්ත විනය. එහෙම නැත්නම් සේවා දායකින්ගේ විනය. ඉන්ඩස්ට්‍රියල් ඩිසිප්ලින් ඔය එම්ප්ලොයි ඩිසිප්ලින්. Right. Then you know, good discipline corrects as well as punishes. Good discipline corrects as well as punishes. Kara nivardi vinayakadi niravadya kirimat danduwan dimat kina dekama wenna. So basically under discipline, what we have to do is correcting wrongful employee behavior. Ekena waradi sewadayaka charyawa nivardi karana. ඒ වගේම willingly or unwillingly we have to or the relevant authority has to punish wrongful employees. So correcting and punishing are there. Correcting and punishing, danduan kirim. Right. Then what is the importance, you know, of this? You know, I mean, why is discipline administration important? Here I have mentioned four reasons. If my memory is correct, yes, four reasons. Have a serious look. Okay, first one is to reduce conflicts and confusions. Dekhane gatum saha vyakulata amakiri. You know, without with conflicts, with confusions, we can't manage, we can't go, we can't achieve organizational goals. Okay, it is inevitable to have conflicts and confusions when different people are there. When different people are there, you know, different people may have different objectives, even though they are working in the same organization. So therefore, it is inevitable to have conflicts and confusions, but they have to be reduced. You know, how can we reduce? Through disciplinary administration, which is, of course, a proper disciplinary management. Then to achieve the objectives and goals of the organization, then to control and manage human resources in an orderly manner. Orderly manner. So you can understand that, you know, it is through that, it is through that employees are the, you know, resources that establish goals, that, you know, create many things. You have learned the uniqueness of human resources, unique characteristics associated with human resources, you have learned. I hope you can remember them. So please never forget that. You know, they are, you know, the very important things relating to human resources. They are, yes, you know, employees, you know, they have the, or who have the creativity and innovation, not other resources. Also, you know, the value of human resources gets increased when the time passes. Also, the essence of management is decision making. Then human resources, the employees, or at least a certain employees, a certain group of employees make important decisions, very important decisions, with regard to utilization of various resources in order to achieve goals of the organization. But also similarly, please try to understand that employees or some employees, they may destroy organizational activities. They may hinder activities done by other employees. They may, you know, because of jealousy, because of other contaminated objectives, they might destroy lives, professional lives of a very important employees. Therefore, we have to, you know, there must be an order. You know, there must be the peace. Therefore, we have to control and manage human resources. From time to time, when you listen to news, Sri Lanka news, you will understand, you know, so many bad things have been done, or so many bad things are being done by human resources. Then, you know, that's why, you know, some owners, some top managers, you know, they decide to use automation, robotics, automations, you know, machines instead of employees, because they make a lot of conflicts, confusions, troubles, disorders, corruptions, bad things in simple. But anyway, there are very good human resources. With such very good human resources, of course, we have to achieve organizational goals. Without such valuable human resources, nothing can be achieved. Can you remember Matakai Nede? Other resources make things possible. Only human resources make things happen. Here the human resources mean good things. And the happening means good happening. You know, good people. Not good things, good people. Abhi thing kiyala kiyanna ba ne neda? Things kiyala kiyanne non-humans. Machines, money and equipment, tools, what nappy things skill again? Human resources, human means, right? Then to ensure the employees behave in accordance with performance standards, rules and regulations of the organization. Okay, right. Then look at this picture. Employees accept fair, equitable, and consistent discipline. Mukadda meke theru. What is the meaning of this? Employees accept fair, sadharana, equitable. Kraikata api sadharana ekenne apakshapati kiyala api ki equitable and consistent discipline. විනාශ වෙන්නේ නැතිව යන අද එකක් හෙට එකක් අනිද්දා දෙකක් ඒ විදිහට නීති රීති වෙනස් නොකර ඒලා consistent rules and regulations we must have. It doesn't means that you know we can't change rules and regulations. No, we can't change, but we can change appropriately, but at the right times. Not every day, not every month, not every year. Kai consistent discipline kila kiyanne eka. Sapa athwasema edakota making me picture ekak api mula dharmayak gattot ema we have to you know discipline administration has to be fair, equitable and consistent. Right. Now we are going to learn you know certain concepts, certain theories under discipline administration. Right. First types of discipline. You know, there are different types of discipline. So at least there are two major types of discipline. So they are preventive discipline and corrective discipline. Preventive discipline and corrective discipline. Walakwalime winning. Preventive discipline. Corrective discipline. In Sinhala we call Niravadhya winning. Niravadhya winning. So what is preventive discipline? A preventive discipline is action taken to encourage employees to follow standards and rules so that infractions do not occur. Infractions mean violations. So rules and regulations are there in the organization. They have to be adhered to. They should not be violated. They should not be violated. So in order to prevent violations, If we take actions, those actions come under preventive discipline. Preventive discipline. So we encourage employees in order to adhere to rules and regulations of the organization under preventive discipline. Then what is the objective of preventive discipline? That is to encourage employees self-discipline. There is something called self-discipline. Swayam vinaya. Swayam vinaya vardhane kirima dirimat kirima tamai niravadhya vinaya moolika parama moolika aramana the basic object. The may self discipline kiyeneka is a very very important thing. So what do you mean by self discipline? Are you a person of self discipline? Mokadda swayam vinaya kiyala kiyanne oba swayam vinayen yutu pudgalayen swayam vinayen yutu pudgalay මෙන්න මේ ලක්ෂණ තියෙනවා බලන්න ඔබටත් තියෙනවද කියලා there should be You know, there should be these characteristics for a person who can be considered as a self-disciplinary employee or self-disciplined employee. You know, check whether you possess these characteristics and to what extent they are being possessed by you. Accept rules which happen to face. Again, tamanta munadimata siduwana reethin piliganna. Accept. They respect the rules. Reethi walata garu karana. Respect. Then observe the rules by him or her willingly. Kemanthi e regulasi reethi reethi neethi reethi regulasi api emagim simply reethi observes ekena harita ara sil rakinawa wage rakin observes meda rakinawa kiyana adahase inne observes then needs no other to direct or supervise him or her to adhere rules thawa kawuruth awashya ne taman dannawa taman hasirinne kohomada kiyanne taman dannawa taman anugamane kaleida taman garu kaleida neethi reethi monawada kiyala esa thawa kawuruwat awashya ne taman hasuruwa. You know, so if you are a self-disciplined person, you don't need even me. You don't need teachers. You don't need others. You know, to control yourself. You know how to control yourself. And then keeps on adhering to rules continuously. Then me, reethi anugamane karanni, evata anukoolo jeevath denni, me davasat dekak maasayak avuruddak nemi, continuously, akhandam. This continuity is there. So keeps on adhering to rules continuously. So therefore, if you are a self-disciplined person, you know, you accept the rules which are available, which have to be followed. Then you respect them. Then you observe them, you know, with willingness. You don't need other people to supervise you with regard to adhering to rules. And also, you continuously do that adhering. Do that adhering. Prevention is better than cure. Kilala tina. Walakpalima vada hundai. Sokirimata. Sokirimata vada walakpalima vada hundai. Prevention is better than cure. So likewise, you know, preventing accidents is better than, you know, correcting accidents. Correcting accidents and correcting the, you know, all the bad consequences, you know, which occurred because of accidents. Preventing accidents. And ඒ වගේ දෙයක් තමයි මෙතන. අනතුරු වළක්වාලීම වඩා හොඳයි. අනතුරු ඇති වුණාට පස්සේ කටයුතු කරන්නට වඩා. ඒ වගේ තමයි මේක. විනය නීති රීති උල්ලංඝනය සිදු වෙන ඉස්සර වෙලා කටයුතු කරන්න. Before disciplinary rules violations occur, happen. We try to control the work and behavior of employees. Of course, by communicating. Here, you know, it's a very important management action that the organization has to do is communicating. Communicating. Okay, they can rules, regulations, then communicate. There may be preventive discipline. It is essential to communicate the relevant rules to everyone concerned. Every employee. So there are some areas that if there are certain rules which employees cannot understand, then, you know, employees have to be taught about them. You know, have to be trained on them. Right. Then the next corrective discipline. Then kochchara vandata vinaya neethi reethi sahas karala eva pilibanda avabodayak laba deela. දුණුවක් ලබා දීලා කටයුතු කරත් ඔබට පේනවා ඇති ඔබ තේරුම් ගන්න ඕනේ මිනිස්සු වැරදි කරනවා නීති රීති උල්ලංඝනයන් සිදු වෙනවා සමහර තැන්වල පුදුම විදිහට උල්ලංඝනයන් සිදු වෙනවා ඒක හරිම ප්‍රශ්නයක් ලංකාව වගේ රටකට ඒක සෑහෙන විදිහට බලපාන සෑහෙන උත්සාහ කරනවානේ අපි දිනු වෙන්නේ you know. So therefore, even though there are rules and regulations, and even though employees have been trained on on rules and regulations, even though employees have been properly communicated about those things, even though employees have been requested by the relevant managers not to violate rules and regulations. You know, there are at least certain employees, they do violations. When there are violations, or after violations occur, then we have to do certain things. Those things come under corrective discipline. So it is an action that follows infraction of rules, and it seeks to discourage further infractions so that future acts will be in compliance with rules and regulations. So it involves corrective actions which discourage repetition of rule violations. So typically, corrective action is a penalty of some type and is called a disciplinary action. Vinayanukula Kriyamarga ekkala thamai kiyanne medena danduwa. Ekena corrective action niravadya kriyamarga illa yamma aakarika danduwa. Thore danduwama kiyana danuwama handunnawa paribhashika wachaneki disciplinary action vinayanukula kriyamarga. Okay, therefore, under corrective discipline, we have to do punishments. We have to give punishments to the employees, you know, who have violated certain rules. And then activity 13.1. Explain the objectives of a disciplinary action. Disciplinary action kiyala kiyanne punishment. Sanction kilat kiyana. Penalty kilat kiyana. Okay, punishment, sanction, penalty, disciplinary action. Explain the objectives. Munada aramun, disciplinary action nigga. Can you think of what are the objectives of punishing? Why do we punish wrongful employees? Why do we punish employees who had done wrong things, who had done violations? Samanya vinayaka thiyena ekena e kale atheete thibuna approach ekak, you know, in the history there was an approach called negative approach to discipline. Ekena rina pravesha. So rina pravesha siduwene pudgala ekko ඝාතනය කරනවා එහෙම නැත්නම් පුද්ගලයාට සෑහෙන අපවාදයක් කර දෙනවා පුද්ගලයාව නිකන් සමාජයේ ලක් කරලා නිඳාවට ලක් කරලා අන්න එහෙම කටයුතු කරනවා උඹ පුද්ගලයාගෙන් පලි ගන්නවා you know in the history you know under negative approach so if we follow negative approach to discipline then there is retaliation there is giving a discredit to the employee නමුත් මෙතන දැන් without retaliation without giving discredit without making employees feel despicable ekena bohoma ninda sagata tattayak walakwala katayutu karana praveshayata kiyana a positive approach to discipline ekena dhanavada praveshaya positive approach so under positive approach to discipline there are at least three objectives of punishing. The first one is to reform the offender. This is the first one. To reform the offender. Ekenne pratisanskarane ga varadde mudawa ganna to reform the offender. Okay, then to deter others from similar actions. To deter others from similar actions. Similar actions. Anithaya bayaganna. Bayagannala e wage veradi kriyamarga walin walakwa. Anuthuru angawana to deter others from similar actions. Now that is also an objective of a disciplinary action. Then to make RR effective. Ekena paladayi karanna rules and regulations. Riti regulasi පළදායි කරන්න ඕනේ. එහෙම නැත්නම් ඒවා නිකම් ඔහි කඩදාසිවල ඔහි වාර්තාවල ඔහි ප්‍රතිපත්තිවල තියෙන දේවල් විතරයි. කිසිම හිරිකිතයක් නැතව ඒවා කිසිම හිරිකිතයක් නැතුව ඒවා උල්ලංඝනය කරනවා. උල්ලංඝනය කරපුවාම කිසිම ප්‍රතිපාකයක් නැහැ. ඒතකොට නැවත නැවත පුද්ගලයෝ ඒවා කරනවා. You know, without any shame, you know, it is possible that employees violate the same rules. Same rules. If there are no punishments, if there are no consequences, you know, when there are rule violations, there must be consequences for those violations. Otherwise, you know, how can we develop? How can we have the smooth running, the order, the peace? Enisa. මේ රූල්ස් and regulations ඉෆෙක්ටිව් කරන්න පනිෂ්මන්ට් දෙන්න ඕන. ඒකට මිනිස්සු දන්නවා අන්න රූල්ස් කියලා જાතියක් තියෙනවා, regulation කියලා જાතියක් තියෙනවා. ඒවා කඩ කරොත් ප්‍රතිපාක ලැබෙනවා. You know to all right, so these are three objectives. So normally, yes, these three are from Werther and Davis. Professor Werther, Professor Davis, I took these three objectives. Okay, all right. You can add another one for, you know, something like maybe taking, you know, some objectives of discipline, you know, to achieve. Okay, to achieve objectives of discipline administration. That is another objective of punishment. To achieve objectives of discipline administration. All right. Right. Okay, I got one response from one student. Yes, to prevent future violations. Correct. Right. Now, another learning unit. The theory of a well-known theory in discipline management, the hot stove rule. Professor Douglas MacGregor, if my memory is correct, introduced this theory, the hot stove rule theory. And the hot stove rule, the hot stove kiyala kiyanne mokak? Rattu unduna. Rattu undun reethi. The hot stove rule. Now that states that disciplinary action should have characteristics similar to the consequences a person suffers from touching a hot stove. Okay, there is a hot stove. Look at here. This is, you can see here, this is a hot stove. That is an apparatus used for cooking. Okay, so then if a person touches the hot stove, what will happen? There are consequences. So like burning. So therefore, the consequences a person suffers from touching a stove, you know, there are similar actions, similar characteristics. When it comes to discipline also, a disciplinary action should have characteristics which are similar to the consequences that a person gets, suffers, because of touching a hot stove. Right, according to this rule, the discipline should have following characteristics: warning, immediacy, consistency, impersonally. The warning kila kiyanne avadakiri. Avadakiri. Kiyanne anathuru engavi avavade. Then immediacy kila kiyanne appramada shanikatve in Sinhala. Consistency again, anurupikatva. Even that anurupata. Impersonally, again, again, apaudgalikatva. Even that apakshapatitva. Okay, you are supposed to learn in detail. What is this? What are these things? Describe the characteristics of the hot stove as an activity I have mentioned, 13.2. Right. Okay, look at here, this picture. So advanced warning. Althia avadaya den. Daikin adas karanna mokak? What does it? Right, there is a hot stove. It says that do not touch. If touch, you will get burnt or burnt. Burnt, burnt, both are correct, meaning according to English grammar. Right. So there is a hot stuff. The hot stuff we got here. Rattu undunatthi na eking avadaya deno allan depa. Alluth pichen. So likewise, there's a system of discipline. There has rules and regulations. You know, it tells that don't violate rules and regulations. If you violate, you will be, or you are going to be punished. You are going to be punished. That's the meaning of advance warning. Then immediacy. Shanika. You can rattu undunatta. අත තැබූ සැනින් මොකද වෙන්නේ අත පිච්චෙන ඒ කියන්නේ අත දැන් අද දැන් මේ දැන් මේ මොහොතේ රත් වඳුරට අත තිබ්බොත් එහෙම තව පැයක් විතර ගිහිල්ලා තව දවසක් විතර ගිහිල්ලා තමයි මේ පිච්චෙන්නේ එහෙම දෙයක් නැහැ ඒ කියන්නේ පමාවක් නැහැ රත් වඳුරට අත තැබීම එතකොට මේ වේදනාව දැනීම අතර You know, if you touch the hot stuff, immediately you will get the burning sensation. Burning, the pain, you will get it. You will feel it as soon as you touch the hot stuff. Therefore, there is no delay between the act of touching and act of feeling the pain, burning sensation. There's no considerable delay. Salakyutu pamavakne. ඒ අල්ලන ක්‍රියාවයි දඬුවම් ලැබි කියන්නේ වේදනාව දැනීම අතරේ සැලකිය යුතු ප්‍රමාවක් නැහැ අන්න ඒ වගේ similarly there should not be a considerable delay between violating and punishing between violating and punishing when an employee has violated a certain rule without delay we have to give a punishment we have to work on that you know we have to work on that with a considerable delay we should not decide punishments ekena goda pama vela punishments denna deela wadak ne ai ema wadak wenna thi why samallada waradda karai kiyala matakatta thiyenne punishment ekak giyawurudde ekena violation ekak giyawurudde une me awurudde medadi punishment ekada samallada amathakai siddhi namathakai vaartha vinasha karanna puluwa you know it is natural that people can't remember you know even the violator samalada violator noyku bara eka naraka wacana pawichchi karanna puluwa yam kisi waradda eken vimasana kora ethora dan ewa wacana pawichchi karai kiyala mathak nathi it may be natural you know actually assume in the last year a person did a bad thing and then at the inquiry the person mentioned a lot of bad words but now assume 8 months have gone the person naturally cannot remember it's possible what he has uttered what he has said is possible samalaata you know there's a possibility of stealing records important records which can be used as evidence saakshi vasin paichiganna puluwa records vaartha methi wenna puluwa edo noyku tarjana gaale noyku deval wenas wenna puluwa bribes denna but it's possible to give bribes to the person who is supposed to you know decide the punishment tagrilla bribes deliverilla punishment ekin galawenna puluwan thing emba wenawane kiyanna onna apeena udaharana thiyena ona tar Sri Lankawen udaharana ona tar ganna puluwan ne hari police wartha wenas karana thawunikutta wenas karana vena buru dewal dahana right okay so therefore then metana making adhas karanne immediacy kiyana eka thawath ekak dear students please understand this on the spot we should not punish you know that is not the meaning of immediacy the meaning of immediacy is that there should not be a considerable delay between the act of violating and the act of punishing the act of punishing considerable delay ekak tiyenna ba kiyana ekai kiyanne on the spot දඬුවම් කළ නොකළ යුතුයි මොකද on the spot සාමාන්‍යයෙන් කියන්නේ psychologically it is dangerous දැන් කෙනෙක් විශාල වැරද්දක් කරනකොට ඒ මොහොතේම දඬුවම් දෙනකොට emotional it is possible that you know the punishment can be decided emotional එහෙම වෙනවනේ දැන් 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 ඔය දැන් emotional actions දැන් විශ්වවිද්‍යාල level එකට වෙලා තියෙනවනේ දැන් අපි දුමුකෝ අත්වැරද්දක් නිසා හරි අත්ත වශයෙන්ම කාර්මික දෝෂයෙන් නැතා වාහනයකින් අපි දුමු සරසවි ළමේ පාරේ පයින්කොට වාහනයට හැප්පෙනවා ඒතොර දැන් මේ මිනිස්සයා ඩ්‍රයිවර්ට අත්ත වශයෙන්ම ඒක පාලනය කරන්න උත්සාහ කරා චේතනාවෙන් සෑහෙන උත්සාහ කරා නමුත් බැරි වුණා එතකොට දැන් ඒ අවට ඉන්න ළමයි අපි තු 20 දෙනෙක් විතර එනවා ඉමෝෂන්ස් වෙනවා අයියෝ ළමයා මාරුයි ළමයාට සීනත් වෙලා ලේ ගලනවා එතකොට දැන් එයාව සමාල්ලාට එයාව ඉස්පිතාලට දාන්න ඉස්සරෙල්ලා අරමනුස්සයට ගාන වේ අරමනුස්සයට පනිෂ්මන්ට් එක දෙන්න කාර් එක පුච්චන්න පුළුවන් එහෙම වෙලා තියෙනවා බස් ඉදන් පුච්චලා තියෙනවා එහෙම අනාගතේ නෙමෙයි අතීතේම වෙලා තියෙනවා තේරුණාද so I have no time there are so many examples in my mind okay so therefore you know if you when a person you know did a bad thing and then if you are going to give a punishment to that person on the spot that punishment may be too harsh because it is based on you know emotions rather than thoughts rather than reasons okay so that's why right then the impartial what is the meaning of impartiality apakshapaditte ekeng adas karanawa impartially consistency anurupatawa da metana meke eka hatarata dakwa dena me thunata dakwa dena thora mama impartiality kiyana eka metana dakwe hatara wenna so I have mentioned that as the yes fourth number right so okay don't worry right in consistency kiyana mokadda thora api eka bala eka stay consistent දැන් පුද්ගලයා දැන් දැන් ඔබ 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 කියලා හිතන්නක දැන් මුදුනට අත තියෙන පුද්ගලයා. ඒතොර ඔබ ඇඟිල්ල විතරක් පාවිච්චි කරලා මුදුනට අත තියෙනවා. අත් මුදුන. ඒතොර ඇඟිල්ල විතරයි පිච්චි. ඇඟිලි දෙකක් පාවිච්චි කරොත් ඒ මුදුන අල්ලන්නට ඇඟිලි දෙකම පිච්චි. ඒතොර සම්පූර්ණ අතම තියලා ඇල්ලුවොත් මුළු අතම පිච්චි. ඒතොර ඒකෙන් අදහස් කරන්නේ මොකද්ද? අල්ලන ප්‍රමාණයට සමානයි පිච්චි. पिछन प्रमाण अलू प्रमाण समान ये ओके ये विनय की दंडुमे तरम वेरदी तरम समान दंडुम दंडोड़ वेरद सरल दंडुम वेरदे प्रमाण दंडुम समान इटवाड़ वेडिहो अडू नोवे इटवाड़ा वेडिहो अडू नोवे अनेक तम कंसिस्टेंसी की दास्कर anurupikatve kina mooladharme you know this we can consider as a principle yes consistency you know assume you are the person who is going to touch the hot stove if we use only one finger to touch the hot stove only that finger will get burnt if you use two fingers to touch the hot stove those two fingers will get burnt if you use the entire palm will get burnt that means the degree of touching is equivalent to degree of burning so likewise similarly when it comes to discipline the degree of punishing should be equal to degree of violating the gravity of a punishment should be similar to the gravity of the violation understood right then what is the meaning of impartiality the impartiality kiyala kiyanne dan da oba rattu unduna elluwa pichchena mama elluwa pichchena ah me upasara ayyo puchchana hondane me mai so and so ehema ekak ne mama elluwa pichchena oba elluwa pichchena vice chancellor elluwa pichchena avakawara elluwa pichchena ona kene yani pirimiye e wenasak ne me pradhaniya apradhaniya wenasak ne ස්වාමියා ස්වාමීන් වහන්සේ මෙයා පාද වෙනසක් නැහැ. you know එනිසා හැම කෙනෙක්ම අල්ලුවොත් හැම කෙනෙක්ගේම පිච්චීම ඇති වෙනවා. ආයකින් අදහස් කරන්නේ මොකද්ද? කවුරු ඇල්ලුවත් පිච්චීම සිදු වෙනවා. ආ ඒ වගේ තමයි විනයට ආවා. කවුරු වැරද්දක් කරලා දඬුවම් දී දඬුවමේ ප්‍රමාණය වෙනස් වෙන්න පුළුවන්. අහවලා මෙයා නමනලා දඬුවමේ ප්‍රමාණය වෙනස් වෙන්න පුළුවන්. නමුත් ප්‍රමාණය වෙනස් විය හැකි වෙනස් විය හැකි වෙනස් ඒක ෂුවර් නෑ නමුත් කවුරු වැරද්ද කළත් දඬුවම් කළයි තේරුණා ඔකේ so if you okay When you touch the hot stuff, you will get burnt. When I touch the hot stuff, I will get burnt. You know, the hot stuff, you know, does not stop burning me. Ah, this is Upasa. By identifying this is Upasa, Upasa is so and so. So therefore, I should not burn Upasa like, you know, this instrument, this hot stuff, you know, apparatus doesn't work like that. You know, it doesn't discriminate people. Whoever touches, he or she gets burnt. You know, the boss, he doesn't, you know, this is the boss, this is the subordinate, this is a monk, this is a reverend, this is a, you know, so like, it doesn't consider. Whoever touches, he or she will get burnt. Likewise, whoever, when it comes to discipline, whoever violates, he or she should be punished. The degree of punishing may be different, but anyhow, whether we should punish or not, there's no difference. There's no argument. Whoever violates, he or she should be punished. Right. So therefore, you know, four principles we can learn from this theory. Four important principles that we can learn, which we can use under corrective discipline. Principle one, we have to, you know, give a warning, advance warning. Telling that there are rules and regulations, don't, please don't violate. And then second principle, there should not be a considerable delay between violating and punishing. Then another principle is, you know, whoever touches the hot stove, whoever violates, he or she should be punished. We should not discriminate people when it comes to punishing. When it comes to punishing. Also, the gravity of the punishment should be equal to severity of the violation. Severity of the punishment should be equal to gravity of the violation. Right. Then next concept, sandwich model. What is this sandwich model? Can a sandwich aakruti kila api singalin? You must have tried, you must have eaten a sandwich. There's no doubt about that. Right? What is a sandwich? A sandwich is like this. This is a sandwich. A picture of a sandwich. Here, you know, this is upper slice. This is down. Slice. In the middle, you know, there are certain things. Maybe salmon, maybe vegetables, maybe, you know, meat, I don't know. Maybe sambal, no, I don't know. But there is something, right? So then here the upper slice, you know, here upper one, we use, you know, here this is an analogy, you know, in a way, it's an analogy. For this one, we use here, this one also analogy, you know, upamavak migitthi. Here there is an analogy. Upamavak yodagina tamai api padali gati. Rattu unduna karayi. Here also we can use that. Then we upper making, uda kyanne, you know, positive comment gati. Positive comment. Down also positive comment. Then in the middle, that's a negative comment. That is about the wrongful act. That is about the wrongful act. Okay, look at here, the definition, right? This is an approach that does not involve a discussion. And it is more one-way communication. Again, discussion, one-way communication. Sandwich approach refers to that. A corrective comment is sandwiched between two positive comments in order to make the corrective comment more acceptable. More acceptable, according to Professor Werther, Davis, etc. Right. So corrective comment is sandwiched between two positive comments in order to make the corrective comment more acceptable. Again, corrective comment, nirvadya comment, ඒ කියන්නේ වැරද්දට වැරද්දට වැරද්ද පෙන්නලා ඒ වැරදි මෙන්න මෙහෙම වැරද්දක් වෙලා තියෙනවා. ඒක මේක හරි නැහැ කියලා අන්න ඒක තමයි corrective comment. There is something wrong. This is not good. This has to be avoided. This is wrong. That is corrective comment. This corrective comment is sandwiched between two positive comments. Then positive comment one, positive comment two. Okay, look at this here. Right, the activity as an activity, discuss an example that applies the sandwich model. Right, now I'm going to discuss an example. Sandwich feedback technique. Now praise is here, positive comment. And then here also negative comment. Here also positive comment. Positive comment one, positive comment two. This one is sandwiched between these two. This is the boss who is trying to, discipline this employee who is a subordinate, who has done a wrong thing, has done a violation. The mehema karapuhama unda deyak kiyala ekeni thawa singalen kiyana nam olu athagala tokkari denna ada enala itwas apa olu athagala e wage wena etakota psychologically මනෝවිද්‍යාත්මක මේ 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 වැරද්ද පිළිගන්න ස්වභාවය වැඩි කියලා හොයාගෙන තියෙනවා. Psychologically there's a higher tendency of accepting the bad thing, wrongful act. Because there are some people, they have done a bad thing, but they don't accept that they have done the bad thing. They have violated, they don't accept. Right. Okay, types. Okay, this is an example. Your punctuality is good, positive comment. But your absence without informing creates serious issues. Ekena danundin nathuwa wedata nopaminima nisa noyukut ita barapatala prashna athi wenna. However, your work is not in arrears. Meka positive ekak. Kohoma namuth obage weda wala hingiyak naha. Weda tika hariyata kerilla thiyena kiyana eka adasa. Relevant duties have been performed. They are not in arrears. This is positive comment two. This is positive comment one. Your punctuality is good. But this is the negative comment. Another example. Assume that, I am the boss. You are the subordinate. Yesterday you were late. You were late by 15 minutes. Then I ignored that. Yesterday I ignored it. Then today also you were late. This time, how many minutes you lost? How many minutes? Assume 30 minutes. 30 minutes. You were late today also. Then the lose, you're losing, 30 minutes. For 30 minutes, you were late. If I am going to ignore today, then I am not a good manager. I will not be able to manage discipline. You manage your discipline, and also maybe I will not be able to manage discipline of others. Why? The adatmama nissaddavi. Today also, I will ignore. What will happen? Right. Okay. There is a question from a student. What's if he has done only bad things, nothing to praise? Right. Okay. That is also possible. Yes. Theoretically, that is possible. Practically, also possible. Correct. If there are only bad things, the person has done, then there is nothing to praise. Correct. But anyway, we must be enough intelligent to find out one good thing at least. Normally we have to believe that for all the bad people, there are certain things, at least very few things, so at least one thing that we can find as positive. We should be enough intelligent to find that one. But the other thing is practically, if there is a person who has done a lot of bad things, of course there's no point of keeping that person for the organization. We have to take a serious punishment, that is dismission. Then we should not keep such people. You should not keep such people. Emai api tiyaganna onne. Hari? Okay, generally, yes, that's why, okay, there must be certain, there must be good things, right, yes. There must be good things to praise. Then, my example now, you know, today also you were late with 15 minutes, no, with 30 minutes. And then I will call you to my room. Then I will tell you, you know, I am really happy about what you are doing. About your performance, I am really happy. That is positive comment one. Positive comment one. Then I will tell the negative comment. However, you know, you were late for 15 minutes yesterday, but I ignored by considering your good performance, your good performance. But today also, you did the same violation. Today also, you did the same violation. And then that is, you know, that is serious. That is going to, you know, that is a violation, correct? Then punctuality, I know, punctuality, ඒ වැදගත් වෙන්නේ කියන එක වුණත් පැහැදිලි කරන්න පුළුවන්. ගොඩාක්ම කාලය ගත කරන්න අවශ්‍ය නැහැ. We should not take much time, but anyway, if the person cannot understand, then we have to make the person understand the importance of punctuality. But generally, we can assume that if there are proper trainings and inductions, these people should understand the meaning of punctuality and all these things, and the importance of rules. Rules. All the rules are important. Some rules are very important, right? Then, you know, after telling that negative comment, then I can tell again another positive comment, another positive comment too. Otherwise, you could have become one of the best employees under me. Otherwise, you could have become one of the best employees under me. එහෙම නැත්නම් ඒක මේ වගේ වැරද්දක් නැත්නම් ඔබට පුළුවන් yet you are not the best employee, or you are not the one of the best employees, because you have certain bad things. But I assume this is the only bad thing, right? Then even I can tell you this is the only bad thing, then please get corrected, then you will be better, or you may become even the best under me. I mean under the subordinates. You know, in the subordinates, under my management, under my control. Right. Any questions? Okay, then progressive discipline. Vardhita Vinaya. In Sinhala, we call Vardhita Vinaya. What is Vardhita Vinaya? Progressive discipline. That means that there are stronger penalties for repeated offenses. Repeated offenses. Punaravartane karana lada. Ekena navatha navatha kada karana lada. Vinaya Varadhi Sambandhin, stronger penalties then. You know, when the employee repeats the same violation, then the gravity of the punishment will get progressed, will get increased. Gravity of the punishment. Again, dandu me barapatalakama enden veduvin. You know, navata ekama varadda sidu karanawa. Samahalata vena varadu wennat puluwa, ekama varadda wennat puluwa. That may be the same violation or maybe different violations. What is the purpose of progressive discipline? That is to give an employee an opportunity for self-correction before more serious penalties are applied. Can ekka paatama viniya bella kapala naththam yemakkala vinasha karala danna nathuwa, because to err is human, to forgive is divine. No one is freed from faults, errors. Normally we believe those statements. To err is human. Varadhima means gatya. No? To forgive is divine. Samavadhima deva gatya. No one is freed from faults. Kavurat varadhivalin. Nidhas pudgalekne. But anyway, we can't keep people, you know, who are repeating those things. You know, we can give forgiveness, no problem. But when repetition happens, further, you know, we can't do that. Therefore, we have to increase the gravity of the punishment. This is an organization. There are so many things to be done in an organization. There are goals and objectives of an organization. They have to be accomplished. Therefore, we can't do that if there are people who are repeating offenses. Right, the progressive discipline is as follows. Now I'm going to give you an example. Verbal warning. For the first offense, verbal warning එකක් දෙන. කියන්නේ පළවෙනි වැරද්ද වුණාම verbal warning එකක් දෙන. අපි තමයි කෝ වැරද්ද මොකද්ද? Let us take a rule. අවසර නැතුව ආයතනයෙන් පිට වෙලා යනවා වැඩ කරන වෙලාවට. Without getting the permission from the relevant office in charge, the person goes out while on duty. The person should be within the organization, but the person went out without getting permission. Now the person is somewhere, not within the organization. Again, Sangvidhana ඇතුලේ නෙමෙයි ඉන්නේ දැන්. පිට ගිහිල්ලා කොහේ හරි. පිට නේද ගිහිල්ලා එහෙම නැත්නම් වෙන තැනකට ගිහිල්ලා වෙන ආයතනයකට ගිහිල්ලා එහෙම නැත්නම්. නෝ. අර අපි හිතමු දැන් ඒ වගේ රූල් එකක් තියෙන්නේ ඇයි කියන එක තේරුම් ගන්න ඕනේ දැන්. මොකොත් හේතු නිසා ඒ රූල් එක තියෙන්නේ. ඇක්සිඩන්ට් වෙන්න පුළුවන් වෙනත් දේවල් වලට වැරදි කරන්න පුළුවන්. ඒකට ඒක ආයතනයට බලපානවා. ආයතනයේ දැන් වන්දි ගෙවීම සිද්ධ වෙනවා. ඒක ඇක්සිඩන්ට් එකක් වුණොත් රැකියාව කරන අතරතුර වන්දි ගන්න වෙන ආයතනයේ එහෙම නීති තියෙනවා. You know, if an employee, you know, while on duty meets with an accident, then according to Compensation Act, according to labor law, the organization has to pay, you know, will have to pay a compensation. These are things, you know. Also the, you know, goodwill, we have to think of the goodwill of the organization. Nisa hima reethiyak thiyena. Api ek kada karai kiyala kiyanawa. Assume there is an employee who went out by breaking that rule. And then for the first time we give a verbal warning. Cutting kiyana, cutting avadayak denawa. Vachika avadaya. Assume the employee did the same violation again. And then for the second time, we give a more, severe penalty. Written warning with a record in personal file. This one is somewhat serious compared with this one, more serious. Written warning with a record in personal file. Assume the same employee violated the same rule again for the third time. Then for the third time, we give 1 to 3 day suspension from work. Maybe 1 day suspension without work, without salary, without pay. Or three, we can specify this. Maybe kelimba dawas thunaka padi nathara kara. Em kiyanna pulo? Cutting the salary for 3 days. So in that way we can, you know, decide no problem. Then at the fourth time, suspension for 1 week or longer without pay. And then for the fifth time, if the employer repeats the same violation for the fifth time, then there is dismission. That's the most serious penalty available. Dismission. Nirapahari. Rakyaving nirapahari. Nirapaharima. So therefore, you know, if you use a progressive discipline, it will give a chance to the employees who can get corrected. Sometimes, you know, because of provocations, because of misunderstanding, because of lack of knowledge, some people may make violations. So therefore, we give a chance, right? Okay, for the first time, we are not going to dismiss. Even for the second time, we are not going to dismiss. This, you know, gives an opportunity to the management, also, human resource management, to look at, you know, to examine, to study the disciplinary system, punishment system, whether they are okay or not, whether they have to be changed. Right. This picture also shows an example. Warning and oral reprimand. Reprimand means warning. oral reprimand, then first written reprimand, then second written reprimand, then suspension, then discharge. Or that is dismission. Another example. First offense, verbal coercion. Second offense, written reprimand. Third offense, suspension. Fourth offense, discharge. Perhaps we can go up to 7. Right. Then disciplinary offenses and penalties. Disciplinary offenses and penalties. Basically, there are two types of offenses. Serious offenses and non-serious offenses. Activity 13.4. Identify serious and non-serious offenses that may be committed by employees in the organization. Can you do that? What are the serious offenses? What are the non-serious offenses? Based on your intelligence, based on your general understanding, can you give at least 5 serious, 5 examples under serious offenses, 5 examples under non-serious offenses? Can you give at least 2? First, give serious offenses, serious theft. Okay, we can consider theft. The sabotage, okay, serious, right? Sabotage, theft, bribing, okay, serious. Okay, the punishments for them, right? Dismissal, suspension, all. They are punishments, but here the offenses. Offenses, they are not penalties. වැරදි වර්ග ප්‍රධාන වශයෙන් දෙකක් තියෙනවා. බරපතල වැරදි, බරපතල නොවන වැරදි. බරපතල විසමාචාර. يعني serious misconduct. Serious acts of misconduct. Then non-serious acts of misconduct. බරපතල නොවන විසමාචාර. Working under the influence of liquor. What is that? Is that serious or non-serious? Right. I'm getting some responses from some students. Harm in the goodwill of the organization, serious with inappropriate behavior or inappropriate behavior, right? That is usually an example of a serious offense. Working under the influence of liquor, may be serious, may not be serious. So non-serious, lateness, coming late, coming with lateness. That is a typical example of a non-serious offense. Late attendance. Okay, late attendance. Then what about late attendance, non-serious one? Late attendance. Then failure to inform absence. Failure. To inform absence. Then failure to report minor accidents or loitering. You can only rest the other one, I may know. Among it and in name, it and get loitering. Then failure to wear uniforms. Now, these are some examples. Failure to wear uniforms or safety equipment while on duty. The disturbance to peers, co-employees. The wearing untidy or dirty uniforms. Smoking in a prohibited area. Then failure to maintain an important record. They are some examples of minor violations or non-serious offenses. Right, then some examples of serious offenses. Serious offenses, right? Attacking, bribing, insubordination. That's a serious offense. What is insubordination? Insubordination. What is that? Insubordination. There are serious offenses. Insubordination is a serious offense. serious offense, this one, insubordinate. That means, you know, if a superior gives an official order and the relevant subordinates, you know, refuses it, you know, without giving an acceptable reason, that is insubordination. Ekena sadharana vidhanayak denakota eka paraharana vidhane paraharima varapathala varada, you know, an order, you can't refuse orders, you can't reject orders if they are, you know, legal, if they are managerial right, legally right. Turnover without informing normally, assume the person has already gone, then there is no person to punish. There is no person to punish. But of course, you know, if the employee has not submitted the important documents and has not submitted all the relevant properties belonging to the organization. You know, I'm responding to a question, you know, asked by a student, turnover without informing, is that serious something? Right. May be serious or may not be. You know, if the employee has, you know, not submitted the relevant documents, has not, given the relevant properties belonging to the organization, and the employee went with all the company properties, you know, certain, then that is serious. And of course, the, you know, company has to take actions against the person who resigned, though the person is not no longer working within the organization. Harming co-workers, of course, is a serious offense. Harming managers, superiors, is a serious offense. Then stealing 100 rupees may not be that serious, but stealing 100 million or 10 million, that is serious, very serious. Seve para harim, seve para harim, kira response ekak thiyena, right? Not working, yes, that is also a violation, but not working, no, yes, correct. So it is up to the organization, you know. That's why, you know, in case of, you know, if we are managing employee discipline in an organization, we have to, you know, decide these things. You know, we have to specify serious offenses. We have to specify non-serious offenses. Right. But there is another point that I should, you know, stress. Before that, it is possible to divide penalties also into two major categories. Minor penalties, major penalties. Then daduma varga dekkada bedanna puluwan. Sulu danduwan, pradhana danduwan. Varapathala danduwan. Verbal warning is an example of a minor penalty. Written warning is an example of a minor penalty. Demotion, dismissal, they are serious penalties. Even stopping salary increment for 2 years, that's a serious punishment, major penalty or major punishment. Okay, so we have to specify those things for proper management of employee discipline. Right, what is this? This is, you know, I want you to be serious here now. I told you that, you know, the offenses we can break or we can divide into two, serious offenses and non-serious offenses. But anyway, practically, you know, some non-serious offenses can become serious. It is possible. Especially, okay, there are certain reasons, you know, there are certain factors which affect in determining the severity and non-severity. There are certain factors. I have mentioned here 5. Nature of the offense, number of previous offenses. This is another thing, right, which I have not mentioned here. But anyway, I want to tell you that. Right, let us take late attendance. This is an example of a non-serious offense. That this may become serious. Why? You know, one reason, you know, repetition. repetition. That make a repeat to now. Repetition. You know, if a minor, you know, offense is repeated by the employee, it can become serious. Pasini watawata parakula pemin. Same in Nerapima, you know. Assume for the fourth time the employee comes with lateness. It is possible to give dismission. You are given nature of the job. Let us take a primary teacher in a school. Primary teacher, you know, gives an exercise to her students, and then she comes to a resting room, and then she gets a nap for 15 minutes. Assume she is pregnant. She is pregnant. Abidham pregnant teacher kene exercise ekak lama inda dila resting room ekata awilla vinadi 15 nidagena nap ekak. Is that serious? That is not serious. That is non serious. Samarita eka offense ekak hadita garan ganna nathi wenne. It is possible not to take it, not to consider it as an offense. But sleeping for long hours, that is definitely while on the duty, is a serious offense. Or for the first time, it's a non-serious one, right? Nature of the job, also depending on the nature of the job. But I say, take another example: security guard, sleeping of a security guard while on duty, that's a serious one. That's a serious one. Because the sleeping of a security guard, you know, will have a more financial impact, more negative impact, a higher level of, you know, negative impact on the organization's success. Sleeping of a security guard. Okay, then another factor, you know, a place. Place of violating. Place of. Abhidhamma is smoking. Smoking is private. Assume one person does it, you know, in a highly inflammable area. You can behave ikmaninma giniganna sulistaneka dumbana. That is a serious punishment. In fact, serious offense, which needs a serious penalty. It's a serious offense that needs a serious penalty. Abhidhamo ema giniganna sulu sthana ekine vechara highly, you know, it's a normal place. An employee does violating that, you know, rule in a normal place. And then that is a non-serious one. Therefore, the place for violating also will determine whether the particular offense is serious or not. Okay, repetition, nature of the job, place of violating, then financial loss of the violation. Ullanghane athiwana moolya paada. If it is high, then it is going to be serious. If it is marginal or if it is very low, then it's going to be a non-serious offense. Okay, so therefore, please remember that exactly. We can't tell that, you know, these are non-serious. And now insubordination, theft, attacking, these are, you know, serious. Exactly, we can't tell. Right, we have to consider certain factors practically. Okay, right now, what is this? You know, factors that determine that affect and determine the severity or non-severity of a punishment. Right, let me say a punishment. The degree severity of a punishment. Let me say of a punishment.
පනිෂ්මන්ට් එක තර නැති තරම තීරණය කිරීමේදී බලපාන සාධක. ද අපේ දඬුවමක් ලොකු දඬුවමක්ද දෙන්න ඕනේ පොඩි දඬුවමක්ද දෙන්න ඕනේ. These factors will be useful. Nature of the offense. වරදේ ස්වභාවය. බරපතල එකක්ද නැද්ද ඒ විදිහට. Nature of the offense. The number of previous offenses. කලින් කළ දින වැරදි. Then the nature of previous offenses. ඒවල ස්වභාවය. The penalties given for similar offenses by other competitors. වෙන තරංකාරී ආයතන given සමාන වැරදි සඳහා given දඬුවම්. Then period of service කොච්චර කාලයක්ද? දැන් අපි හිතමුකෝ අවුරුදු retire වෙන්න ළඟයි. සේවකේ. තාම හොඳට වැඩ කරලා තියෙනවා. නමුත් අවසානාරම් ලොකු වැරද්දක් වුණා. අද මොකද කරන්නේ? Are we going to give a serious punishment or not? Period of service. We have to punish. You know, according to that impersonal principle law, you know, that derived that is deriving from Stav rule theory, we have to punish. We have to punish. But severity of the punishment may be somewhat lenient by considering longer period of service. සමහර අය එක අවුරුද්දයි අය මාස 3ක් ආව මාස 3ෙන් හොරගම් කරා. Then you know we have to give a serious penalty. You know, within 3 months, assume only 3 months, the person came to work. Then the person, you know, did a violation. Whether the compare rules are clear, have they been communicated in reasonable and understandable manner? Now, this is also, you know, these things also we can consider when determining the gravity of the punishment. Okay, then the financial loss, those things, you know. That's why the nature of previous offenses. So, bhavi, number of, right. Also, any provocation. Another reason, any provocation. Again, by trade union or by another person, by trade union lead. Those things we have to consider when we decide the gravity of the punishment. Right. Then domestic investigation. Domestic investigation. That is the last thing that you are supposed to learn today. Domestic investigation. Abhyantara vinaya parikshan. Abhyantara vinaya parikshan. So this is, you know, this is an internal investigation conducted by usually the human resource manager. Human resource manager or the initiated by the human resource manager. Conducted by an impartial committee or an impartial person. Then generally it is an investigation conducted by the particular organization. You know, in case of a set of rule violations, in case of at least one rule violation, which is usually a serious one. For minor violations, we don't normally conduct domestic investigations. Organizations conduct domestic investigations for serious offenses because conducting domestic investigation is expensive. You know, it has a considerable cost in terms of time, in terms of effort, in terms of money. Right. Then when a person is suspended for a rule violation, the organization will have to conduct a domestic investigation, right? That is called internal discipline investigation or domestic inquiry. So what are the steps of conducting such an investigation? Right. First step, do a preliminary investigation. This has to be done by an experienced person, you know, who has won the confidence of the management and also better confidence of employees. If there are trade unions, then the confidence of trade unions. වෘත්තීය සමිතියේ විශ්වාසය ඒවා අග්‍ර කළමනාකරණ විශ්වාසය දිනාගත් පළපුරුදු කළමනාකරණයක් මේක පවත්වන්න ඕන preliminary investigation. The purpose of conducting a preliminary investigation is to collect evidence, සාක්ෂි එකතු කිරීම. You know, is there a real case, you know, is there a possibility of establishing a real case against a particular employee?
who has been accused, who has been suspected for violation or for certain violations. එම accused කරලා තියෙන සැක කරලා තියෙන කෙනෙක් සම්බන්ධ complaint කරලා තියෙන කෙනෙක් සම්බන්ධ the violations you know complaint කරනවා يعني how do you know how does the HR manager know violations okay from complaints made by unknown employees or known employees even from customers complaint by customers complaints or yes complaints from or by security officers ඒ වගේ මාර්ග වලින් දැනගන්න පුළුවන් right then interdict the service of the employer සාමාන්‍යයෙන් මේ වගේ criminal investigation එක report එක දවස් 14 දෙන්න ඕන within 14 days you know this criminal investigation has to be completed and then the relevant report has to be forwarded to the manager who appointed that person then interdict the service of the employer the pramana if there is sufficient evidence against the employee then this decision is taken interdiction of the service of the employer seve nathara karana without normally without pay that samara companies you know some companies you know samara doubts you know if there are serious doubts then all considerable doubts reservations then one thirds of the salary so you know, maybe 40% of the salary can be paid but you know godak saksi thiyenawana there is a you know good amount of evidence against the employee you know who has done a, you know several violations which are very serious then normally the organization doesn't give the pay during the interdiction period issue the charge sheet ana charge sheet ekak kiyala gattiyen ekena charge sheet ekak kiyala api singalen charge sheet kiyala kiyena nemana thai ekak kiyena singalen chodana patraya right chodana patraya nikut kiri ekena charges wenawenama charges karapu waradi walata wenawen if the person has done four violations then there must be four charges tawase ekata explanation call karan issue the charge sheet then next step to receive letter of explanation ekata uttare laba ganna mama ekata waradi karuda nadda mena me hethu nisa mama ek karala ne me hethu nisa mama ek karala thiyena ekena kana kaatu wenawa sorry anagutte ayana the letter of explanation to receive letter of explanation then formal inquiry vidhimat parikshana abidamuko evala thiyena letter of explanation ek pilaganna berina then charge ekak denawane charge sheet ekak denawa adala employee ekota ya danaganna who is now on interdiction then that person has to respond if the person doesn't respond then the organization will again give a reminder send a reminder for that reminder also if the employee doesn't send anything then of course the organization can assume that the person has no answer and then the person is guilty and then the organization can you know can go to this step determine the punishment determining punishment and implementing it without doing a formal inquiry then sevaka pili aragena thiyena nan eth formal inquiry ekak karanna awashya if the employee has accepted that the employee is guilty then no need of conducting a formal inquiry which is also expensive but I assume the employee has not accepted employee has denied pili aragena ne charges chodana evalin mama nidas mena me hethu nisa kela evala di assume those that letter of explanation is not acceptable to the manager then the management can decide to conduct a formal inquiry this is just like court hearing normal court hearing cross questioning and all these aras prashna asim wage dewal godak wenna then trade union yena ayathane ekana you know samara trade union kenek enna pulang sevakayata support ek if there's a trade union then a person from trade union you know, can come to help the relevant employee who has to face this formal inquiry, the accused. Because the niche gunnodan at the, you know, to take the service of a lawyer also, you know, depends on the policy. Determine the punishment and the implementing. And finally, after conducting the formal inquiry, assume it was clear that the relevant employee was guilty, not innocent. And then the punishment has to be decided and then it has to be implemented after deciding. Usually the punishment, the deciding punishment and implementing it, deciding punishment is done by a committee usually, or by the chief executive officer, supported by the, who is supported by the human resource manager. Well, otherwise, you know, there are, you know, so some, there are, there is a committee consisting of senior people, senior managers. Usually the punishment is implemented by the HR department. Okay, there is a question from a student. This experienced person who is going to conduct the investigation, right? This preliminary, I hope, the preliminary investigation should be a completely new person. Now, normally, you know, a well-known experienced person, not a new person, you know, preliminary investigation. There are certain people, you know, in case of a large organization, who are usually requested to do criminal investigations because they are very good. They have very good track records in terms of honesty, in terms of discipline. There are some managers, senior people. They work in Naduhaba Kachal, there may be, you know, certain two or three professors, very senior people, you know, they are requested. By the Vice Chancellor, please, you know, help us to solve this problem. Or maybe, you know, former legal officer, normally an experienced manager with a legal background. Not necessarily, you know, without a legal background also is possible, with a HR background. But formal inquiry, normally, you know, labor officer or the, you know, an outside person normally is invited, not an inside person. Because if an experienced manager is going to conduct a formal inquiry, you know, more likely he or she is going to be biased because that person is a member of the management. So therefore, in order to conduct a formal inquiry, totally an outsider is invited with legal background, preferably human resource management. Plus, you know, our legal background. Okay, so then you are not supposed to learn all the details about these steps. You know, briefly, you are supposed to learn. You are supposed to learn in this class for this class purpose. Okay, all right. Right, management of employee discipline. So I hope now you will be able to achieve these objectives after studying this note, even the video and the relevant materials. You must be able to achieve these objectives, numbering 7 objectives. Okay, define what discipline means, understand importance of discipline administration, then identify types of discipline, preventive discipline and corrective discipline. Then the objectives of giving a punishment under corrective discipline. Negative approach to discipline and positive approach to corrective discipline. Negative approach to corrective discipline. These things were discussed briefly. Then understand the Hart-Gustav rule theory or rule that gives 4 principles. What are the 4 principles? Warning. Then immediacy, consistency, and impersonality. And understand sandwich model and progressive discipline. And identify disciplinary offenses and penalties, serious offenses and non-serious offenses. in some factors which determine, you know, whether certain offense is serious or not. Especially some non-serious offenses become serious because of some factors like nature of repetition, nature of job, place of violation, and then financial loss involved. Then the penalties are also basic. Mainly there are two, major penalties and minor penalties. Then understand briefly domestic investigation. Okay, dear students, could you please explain, okay, there's a question from students. Could you please explain again the difference between fourth and fifth step of domestic investigation? Formal inquiry, you know, this is, you know, to conduct the formal inquiry, because evidence is there, but the relevant accused employee does not accept that the employee, that he or she is guilty. And then, you know, there's a need of conducting a formal inquiry in order to exactly find out whether the person is, the accused is guilty or not. Right, but normally, this informal inquiring officer is not supposed to decide the punishment. Maybe proposals are there. The investigation officer may propose punishments, but really the punishments, you know, the purpose of formal inquiry is to decide whether the accused is guilty or not. Therefore, the main task of a formal inquiring officer is to decide that whether the person is innocent or not, guilty or innocent. Then there's a separate board of discipline or committee that will decide the punishment based on the report. Okay, all right. Okay, then, dear students, please take care. And this is enough for today's session. And okay, see you at the next session.